Okay, Coach. First off, as far as this team goes, talk about what you saw in spring practice that you hope to carry over here to the fall season here in 2011.
Well, we're still youthful. We were a young football team last year, didn't have a whole lot of seniors. Graduated a few really outstanding players, and their leadership will be missed. But we've got a good, strong sophomore class mixed in with some good upperclassmen. I think we have a 26 freshman report. We feel that we're pretty talented there. Good team speed. Again, more game experience than a year ago, so I guess that's a good start. Got to get an answer to the quarterback situation pretty quickly. Got to get the tailback moving downhill. Like, we've got good speed there. We don't have the big backs. We're going to have to play a little bigger than we are. Defensively, I think we've got good team speed, and I think we're going to be strong at the line of scrimmage on both sides of the ball. Tough conference, tough schedule. You look down through that schedule, 5 of the 10 are Division II or in process. So that means there's 50% more aid, to recruit with. Then, we play a fourth game of the year. We got number 2, St. X here. 2 weeks later, we got number 6, Mary here. So, it is the most challenging schedule that we've had. There's 7 or 8 of them there, man. You better buckle up. In the first two, St. Ambrose, we've always struggled on the road out there. And then McHenry, which was a playoff team a year ago in the NAIA, has now made the jump to Division II. So it's going to be a real challenge. I think we're going to be a better football team. Time will, I guess it'll take time to see just how it shows on the scoreboard. Because I think we're going to be really challenged. But I'm confident, our kids are going to play tough. We're going to be better, be a little bit better brand of football.
When you take a look at the quarterback position, Shane Tierney, one of the most accurate quarterback in St. Francis history, one of the most in your entire conference. And between Alex and Justin now, mainly at the quarterback position, what's that competition like right now? And how, I don't want to say pressed for making a decision, but I know you want to get a quarterback in place.
Well, they're not the only two in the mix. There's a few more. I want to make the decision after we've got a couple of preseason scrimmages we want to get through. By Tuesday, August 30th, 3 o'clock, I'll have made a decision who is the number one quarterback at that point. Then we do have another inter-squad scrimmage on that Saturday to either confirm or change.
As far as the quarterbacks, talk about what each individual quarterback that is in the mix for the starting job, what they bring and what kind of talents they have.
Well, Bozier's a fifth-year guy. He's been around the program and he understands things pretty well. He's got a heck of an arm. Maybe the strongest arm we've had here. A kid by the name of Hunsucker that was a redshirt last year, a lot of the same qualities, got 4 years eligibility left. Then you got the two athletes that can run and make things happen, and if bullets were flying in the foxhole, you'd want them next to you, and that's Bierwalder and Miller. Bierwalder had a great spring game. Miller's a great leader. They're tough kids. So we've got a good problem. We've got a pack of them there, they're going to slug it out. We'll make a decision. We're not going to play with a whole bunch of them. It'll come down to one guy, and we'll expect the others to handle it and keep battling them for it.
Defensively, you guys are doing some changes in your scheme. Talk about how that plays into the speed that you guys have, especially in that sophomore class.
Well, we were a combination with a 4-man line and a 3-man line. We've gone pretty much exclusively to three in terms of personnel alignment. But then you bring guys from the second and the third level down, so it kind of looks the same what you had before, but it's a different athleticism. It's a much quicker type of defensive unit than I think what we've had before, because we employed a 4-man line. Don't have the bigger, stronger kid, but we got kids that can really run and fly the ball.
When you take a look at the running back position, you guys have had some pounders there in the past to mix with the speed guys going on the outside. Talk about the role that Frank is going to play, kind of being a little bit of both.
Well, yeah, he's a little light in the shorts compared to what we've had back there the last couple of years. Veek was back there at 225 or so. Frank's probably a 180. It's going to be a little different. You can't expect a guy with different ability to do the same things as somebody else did. So, you got to alter the attack a little bit instead of pounding it. Maybe you got to read it a little bit, run a little more option. You got to do some different things to be creative. So we're trying to tweak and adapt things that we do schematically on both sides of the ball to what we have.
All right. Anything else you'd like to add, Coach?
No, I think you got it.